Friends, myself Dr. Alka Mukherjee. I am a medical legal consultant from Nagpur. We all know C-section, caesarean section is the most common operation performed in obstetrics. So there are more chances of errors and medical negligence on our part in day-to-day performed surgery. So here I came with a new subject, that is medical legal aspects of caesarean section. The first recognized case of obstetric litigation was in 1980 in White House. Since then, the obstetric litigations are on rise. Caesarean section, as we all know, is the abdominal route of delivery after fetal viability. It is the most common operation in obstetric practice. Why obstetrics is the most litigation branch of medicine? There are a few points. We deal with two precious lives and two potent litigants like mother and baby. One is visible, one is invisible. Patients, they are usually young and healthy. Patients and relatives, they consider pregnancy as a physiological process. But we all know obstetrics is full of unpredictability and unforeseen fatal complications. They can happen anytime. And bad outcome is absolutely not acceptable to relatives, and they always label this as negligence and litigate the treating doctors. Why the incidence of caesarean section is very high? Because women, they are getting mother at a later age, maybe because of their education or career. Large size babies in mothers with gestational diabetes and diabetes mellitus. Safe surgeries are there because of safer anesthesia. Caesarean section gives protection to pelvic floor, prevent incontinence of stool, flatus, urine and pelvic organ prolapse. Many patients, they demand caesarean section for these reasons also. There is increased rate of nulliparous pregnancy who are at increased risk of C-section. Maternal autonomy and informed choice in favor of C-section. There is increased risk of litigations that has forced obstetrician to come under defensive practice, which leads to more number of C-section. Early diagnosis of fetal distress, as better monitoring facilities are available. Coming to incidence of C-section in India, they found in overall India has about 17.2% caesarean section birth annually, a number that is slightly higher than the threshold of 15% recommended by WHO, which says that anything beyond could lead to increased maternal and perinatal morbidity as per data published in 2019 March 27. C-section on maternal request. This is a recently introduced indication for C-section, raising the incidence of C-section from 19.37 in 1994 to 28.7% in 2007. But the risk of C-section are higher than vaginal delivery, one should remember. There is a medico-legal problem in doing medically unindicated operations for delivering the baby. There is lack of information and guidelines on non-medical indication of C-section. RCOG advises for taking second opinion, whereas ACOG considers it as ethical. But looking towards ethical codes in practice and evidence-based medicine, the financial aspects, limited resources, we should stick to indicated C-section only. Major abdominal surgery with many complications involved, like those related to anesthesia, surgery and post-operative problems. Maternal mortality is 5 times higher in elective caesarean section and 18 times higher in emergency C-section after vaginal delivery than vaginal delivery. There is increased maternal morbidity in present pregnancy and potential risk of post-C-section in future pregnancy. There are certain prerequisites to be fulfilled for performing C-sections. Let us modify them in 8 P's. The first P is a person. The person should be expected to be, the caesarean section should be expected, should be performed by a gynecologist. If a general practitioner with MBBS degree or a surgeon with MS degree does it, he or she should have approved qualification, training from recognized centers approved by MCI is must. The second P is place. Well-equipped infrastructure with all essential equipments like oxygen cylinders, Boyle's apparatus and defibrillators. Protocols. For checking the expiry dates of the drug, oxygen cylinder filling dates and annual maintenance contract should be maintained. Standards should be followed while deciding the list of drugs, disposables and equipments to be available in the OT. The next P is the pre-operative precautions, which are absolute must. Proper history of previous surgeries and medical problems. The minimum pre-operative investigations like grouping, cross-matching, hemogram, BTCT and urine examination. Documentary evidence of pre-operative instructions to the patient like pre-op starvation and medication, etc. The next P is proper indication and its documentation. Very important to avoid allegations of unnecessary C-section or late C-section and baby suffered. Our documents, they should corroborate with the indications. For example, fetal heart sound record should prove that it was a case of fetal distress. Proper and informed consent is must. Usual allegations like consent not taken, consent taken under pressure, delay in operation after giving consent. The next important P is presence of neonatologist during C-section is necessary, especially if cesarean section is done for fetal indication. Possibility of bleeding in all cases of C-section is present. It is prudent to have blood ready by cross-matching in all cases of C-section or ascertain the availability of blood in blood banks by telecommunication and document that. It should be documented on blood transfusion consent form, which is a separate consent form, and in emergency we might forget to take consent for blood. So in all patients for delivery, you should take consent for blood separately before the delivery or C-section. There are reasons for C-section litigation. In case of maternal death due to any cause, an asphyxiated baby is delivered by C-section at term and dies. Here allegation is made for doing cesarean section late. If baby delivered by cesarean section suffers from cerebral palsy, doctor is held liable if he fails to arrange blood for blood transfusion at the time of actual need. If a foreign body is left inside the abdomen, in case of anesthetic complication, operating doctor is jointly held liable. Injury to urinary bladder or ureter may not be held as negligence, but failure to recognize and manage the injury is negligent. Injury to the baby during delivery may lead to litigation. In case of delay in initiating C-section after fetal distress is recognized, leading to poor outcome. If a complication occurs during cesarean section and doctor manages it with reasonable degree of skill, knowledge and care, without doing or omitting anything that a reasonable competent obstetrician would do, then he is not held responsible for the untoward outcome. There are different types of negligence. Res ipsa loquitur. For means the things speak for themselves. Here the negligence resulted in such an injury that even laymen can understand. Causing burn to patient during anesthesia, leaving sponge or instruments within the body cavity, handing over wrong baby to the patients. These are the few examples. Then contributory negligence. It is the concurrent negligence by the patient and the doctor which causes harm to patient. It is a good defense for the doctor. However, in criminal cases, such defense cannot be taken by the doctor. There are different types of negligence. Professional misconduct. It is a violation of medical code of ethics which may not cause damage to the patients. It is brought before state or central medical council. Punishment is by warning notice or by removing name from the medical council register. What is the course after litigation? You may receive a letter from the complainant or court stating that an obstetrician has been sued. The reply should be sent within 30 days of receipt of notice. The obstetrician should put up all possible points for defense in the first instance during a reply. If points which are not mentioned during reply are put during hearing, they are liable to be rejected. Some points or queries may come in the complaint, and even if they are not asked in complaint letters, obstetrician should mention some points during reply to the complainant. What are the questions which will be raised, like was the cesarean section indicated, what was the indication, was it done at a proper time, was it done by a competent surgeon or with competent anesthetist, what was the type of anesthesia used, whether it was appropriate for surgery. Was the setup appropriate for C-section? Were all the precautions taken to prevent complications anticipated or unforeseen? Was the problem leading to mishap, either baby or mother, detected at a proper time? Was the patient referred to other specialties in time when input was needed? Was the situation conveyed to the relatives in time and from time to time? Was blood available at the time of need? The other thing should be mentioned in reply. qualification, training, experience, expertise of obstetricians with relevant documents, infrastructure of the clinic or hospital and special facility available, some facts regarding previous illness or treatment which might have been omitted in the complaint, inconsistencies in the complaint at different levels through CPA, complaint in court if any, written evidence of consent of patients and relatives stating the inherent or special risk involved in cesarean section is very important. The other things should be mentioned in reply are situation of the case, that is emergency situation, lack of facility should be mentioned, evidence that reasonable knowledge, skill and care exercised by the doctor matter should be quoted from standard textbook. Negligence on the part of patient or patient party, if any, in acceptance of facility should be mentioned. The same queries are also made during hearing. There should not be any discrepancy between reply during hearing and that in the written reply to the complaints. Compensation. If the obstetrician is found guilty or negligent in case of C-section, CPA may direct doctor to pay an amount as compensation to the consumer. In case of civil law, the law of tort, punitive compensation may also be asked for. The damages for which compensation is claimed are loss of future earning, cost of future care, cost to cover physical and mental sufferings, etc. In case of vicarious liability, out of action or omission of duties of other subordinate or deputed staff, the doctor along with the wrongdoer compensate jointly. What are the steps to minimize this cesarean section litigations? MCI approved qualification of operating doctor is must. Judicious and balanced decision for cesarean section considering the well-being of both mother and fetus is ethical. Clear, proper and timely communication with patient and her relatives about the need for C-section, possible complications and long-term effect, if it is done or not done in the language which they understand. Sympathetic attitude and solving all queries of patients. In fact, the whole medical establishment should be made courteous and polite in communication and dealing with the party in case of a mishap in C-section. Proper training to handle aggrieved patient and relatives should be imparted to all the staff. Consent, as in the Samira Kohli versus Prabha Manchanda, the three bench judgment given some guidelines regarding consent. Consent of patient itself is most important, other signing as witness. It should be an informed consent with detailed explanation of nature of treatment, benefits, possible side effect, balanced information not to frighten her, available alternatives, consequences of refusing of treatment, and all these be accomplished during the antenatal classes if they are taken. Consent for C-section doesn't imply consent for other associated procedures like appendicectomy or hysterectomy unless it was life-saving step. With proper mention in the consent, associated procedure can be done like tubectomy or appendicectomy. Consent can actually be taken by our resident doctors, but they should be expert enough just like you to take consent. If patient refuses to give consent, then document informed refusal signed by the patient. If patient refuses to sign the refusal of consent, can get an undertaking about the incident signed by the neutral bystander. Once the consent is given, there should be no delay in doing C-section. Another area prone for litigation is vaginal birth after cesarean section, that is VBAC. Documents should be able to prove that labor was meticulously monitored and OT was kept ready for emergency C-section. Blood not arranged in spite of rare blood group A negative, 35 lakhs of compensation was awarded in one of the cases. Self-auditing and updating and staff knowledge and skill updating from time to time is prudent and essential. If a case needs second opinion or the patient demands, so the doctor should take second opinion. There is a tendency to avoid doing tubectomy with C-section, especially with high-risk patient, because of fear of associated with inquiries of tubectomy complications and death. Following the GOI guidelines of 2006, death or complications during C-section will not be considered as sterilization complication. Insurance has been started by Government of India for doctor's indemnity and patients for any complications of death and failure. One of the most common complications for litigation is sepsis. But these documents, they can save us in these cases like autoclave register, fumigation register, purchase vouchers of disposables. operative notes, post-operative instructions for common gynecological operations including cesarean section, checklist for antenatal investigations, hospital documents and anesthesia related documents. Exercising skill and care in deciding and performing C-section is must. Documentation is the only proof of standard of care a patient has provided. All records should be legible, correct, complete, chronologically placed. Professional indemnity cover is very important. The company should be informed when a complaint or notice being served. Opinion of senior and experienced doctors should be sought about the merits of case. A strong peer support is very useful. So to conclude with, obstetric litigation has a very grave impact on obstetric practice. CPA making doctors to practice defensively, the burden of investigations, the total cost of healthcare has increased a lot. Proper documentation, proper counseling, sympathetic approach, honest and sincere attitude in treating the patients can go a long way in averting any medical legal problem in C-section. Thank you so much.